Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna cover 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 1200 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be one of the funky ways how you can tell if your object in your scene is mirrored or not. So get this, I have 2 teapots. I'm gonna select them, I'm gonna press Alt+X to go to the see-through mode. Now get this, if I click on the right teapot, for example, and if I mirror it, you can notice that the color of the see-through becomes slightly darkish gray compared to the one that's not mirrored. So get this, if you compare these two, you can tell that this one is darker and this one is lighter. Now if I undo, you can actually see that nicely. Look at this, not mirrored, mirrored, not mirrored, mirrored. This is a really cool way of telling that. So get this, if I create a sphere, for example, and the sphere is looking like this, and if I mirror the sphere, it becomes a darker sphere. So yeah, that's one of the ways how we can find out if your object in your scene is mirrored or not. Of course, if you select the mirrored object and you go to Utilities, Reset X Form, and you click Reset Selected, it's gonna turn to its light gray color, so nobody will know that you mirrored an object. Our next feature is gonna be an inbuilt calculator inside of 3ds Max. So get this, whenever you just click on any field that has numbers in and you press Control N, you're gonna get this numerical expression evaluator. And now any math equation that you write here is gonna be calculated and you can input it into that little numbers box that you have in your Max. So look at this, 5 plus 5 divided by 2 equals 7.5. Click paste. And you're done. Before we continue with our features, I just want to give a quick shout out to Evermotion because they have Archmodels Volume 277, 25% off. It's 12 modern wardrobes. If you buy this package, as you can see, you get tons of suits, etc. So you will never have the need to buy a suit for a wedding or something like that, except in real life. As usual, go to Evermotion's website to check the daily news, what's new, who cheated on who. You know how the drama goes in our CGI world. So yeah. Check Evermotion website. Our next feature is gonna be foliage. So whenever you have an interior scene and you wanna add, you know, some sort of tree shadows or something in your scene, you don't need to search for, you know, high quality tree models or whatever. You can just go to standard primitives here, go down to AEC extended, and here you have foliage. Now you can choose between these generic trees. I'm just gonna choose a generic oak. Click on that, boom, you have an oak in your scene. Cool thing is you can determine, of course, its height, you can determine its density, and even the pruning amount. Another cool thing is you can choose level of details, and another cool thing is if you click on a side, you can see that all the leaves are gonna turn into this one blob, making your scene faster. This is super useful if you're doing like super large landscapes. You don't need to use like turbo high detail, high poly detail trees. You can just use tens of thousands of these and you're gonna get a very nice and optimized scene. Our next feature is gonna be a feature where you can turn on or off a modifier in your viewport or render. Now get this, I have a teapot and I'm gonna add bend to it. I'm gonna bend it like this. I'm gonna add push to it, I'm gonna push it like this. And each modifier, if you right click, you have off in viewport, off in render. So get this, if I go to my bend and I open up my render window, so get this, if I go to right click on my bend, off in render, teapot is straight, in viewport we still have the modifier. You can notice you have this little yellowish icon here, which determines what option you're using. For our push, I can go right click and click off in viewport, so push is gonna be visible in render and not in viewport. So yeah, it also comes with a slightly different yellowish icon, but this is a super handy feature so you can turn on and off any modifier in viewport or in render, your choice. And our last feature is gonna be a substitute modifier. Now, substitute is a pretty straightforward modifier, but I don't see a lot of people using it. So what does it do? You literally select a bunch of objects and you replace it with another object. Where is this useful? For example, you have, I don't know, a table set with plates, etc. And your client doesn't like all the plating, so he tells you use a different one. Well, you could just select all of them with one click, replace with everything else, and this is how it works. So for example, I need to replace all these objects with this lovely teapot. As you can see, I really love teapots. Teapots are the best. Anyhow, select all of them, go to your modifier list and start typing substitute. Here it is. And once you apply it to all the objects as an instance, click pick scene object and just click on your teapot. Boom, all of them are teapots. So yeah, this is a super nice modifier. I think it's very underrated. I love it. Anyhow, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Evermotion, thank you for sponsoring this video. And everybody, don't forget to check Evermotion's website for your daily CGI updates and news. See you in the next video. Bye.